Welcome back to another episode of Too Familiar. Welcome back. And as you can see, I have a co-host and I have somebody else with me today. Introduce yourself, co-host.
Baby Sire for another episode, you know what I'm saying? If y'all are getting familiar with my face and y'all want to keep seeing me on the episodes, you know, just put it down in the comments type shit.
He think he replacing my co-host, but nah, we ain't having that. I don't think he ready for that lifestyle. But anyways, y'all know I also had an episode with my best friends back in, I think it was June or July for Best Friends Day. And now I have my other best friend that couldn't make it all the way here in Dallas. Please introduce yourself
and what you do. Yes, I'm Lily Marie. I'm the owner of Zion Air Fashion Hair and Wear. Right now, I'm just doing my designing. I sell hair. You know, I do a little designing on the side.
Makeup. Trying to be all cute and speaking to the mic.
I'm sorry. You know, this is my first time being on something like this. I had to come support my girl. So, you know, I just do hair. I'm into designing. So, that's pretty much it.
Okay.
How long you been doing, fashion design and stuff like that?
To be honest, I've been doing this since high school. Like, I used to always be the little girl that used to make stuff for everybody and stuff like that. But I haven't started making money off of it until probably, like, 2019. That's when I took it serious and I turned it to a business. Because I'm like, you know, it's something that I love to do. It's more than just me getting paid to do it. Right. So I'm like, I'd rather just turn that into a business, do something I love, than, you know, working 9 to 5, which is nothing wrong with that. Not saying that, you know, but it's good to follow your dreams. Like, I feel like a lot of people, they kind of let themselves go because they want to just work towards a better life, but right. They let go of their dreams. And that's just something that I would never do, you know. Mm-hmm. So when I created Zion Air Fashion, it was me creating my dreams and making it into a reality. So, yeah. Okay.
So how did you know, though, that that's something that you want to do? Like, what were you doing to know that, you know, you want to go into the hair business?
So for me, I think it was because my mom, she didn't really do my hair like I liked it. Like, she, you know, pigtails and ponytails, and that wasn't for the girls, for me. You know, growing up, all the girls moved kind of faster. So I used to want to be on a different level. You know, my mom tried to keep me at bay. Right. She was more strict. So I used to try to explore on my own. It's not something that she would let me do. So I used to have to try to just bust my own bubble. And that's how I got into, like, different hairstyles and cutting my hair and different hair colors. I used to go to school with bright pink hair, blue hair, because it was like I'm trying to experience and explore, and my mom was trying to keep me away from it. So I think when you're being restricted, you become more rebellious. Right. So for me, it was something like that, and I was like speaking out through my hair. Mm-hmm. So it just became that for me, and then other people was like, well, I like it. Can you do my hair? And from there, it just went, you know, me doing other people's hair and getting paid to do it. Yeah.
Yeah, she whipped and dipped the hair today.
Something like, just real quick, because I had to come and, you know, support. But, you know, for me, it's something that I just love to do. Right now, I'm not really doing as much as I feel like I should. But for me, it's baby steps. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm on my own pace. I'm not on nobody else's pace.
So you do men's hair and women's hair? You do locks, braids?
Yes, I do. I went to school. I went to cosmetology school. So I'm pretty much certified into doing men's and women's hair. But I do women's hair more often because I make wigs. I cater to women's needs a little bit more. But I'm open to doing kids' hairs, men's hairs, you know, whoever would need me at the time. Because I'm for the people, all people, you know. Whoever need me, I'm coming.
Oh, so not just black people, you do the...
No, for me, I feel like it's... I like versatility. Yes. I want to be able to do any type of person hair. Yeah. So I think the first thing about going to hair school, they don't just teach you about a certain type of hair. They teach you about the basics of doing everybody hair. And I think that was good for me because I learned how to deal with different textures, different people.
Different textures.
So I feel like that's where I got the big ups. Versus a lot of people, you know, I'm not saying nothing wrong with people doing hair and not being certified, but you learning on the street and you going to school and actual learning, you know, what they want you to know, it puts you a little bit higher up. You know what I'm saying?
How long were you in school for?
I had to learn a lot, you know. For me, it was a lot because I was doing hybrid, so I was doing online and I was going in for, like, you know, the salon hours. But I think it was like a 1,500 credits that I had to get.
Right.
You know, so it was some time. It depends on how dedicated you are, how bad you want it. For me, I wanted it bad, so right. I was full time. You could go part time, you know, but I wanted it. I did full time.
In and out.
I was gone. I was like, nope, I need this now. I want to open my shop. This is something that I want to do. I don't want to wait on it because I feel like people wait on stuff. I'm going to do it later. That later turned into never.
Yeah, you got to believe in yourself right now.
Yes, exactly.
Speaking of believing, I mean, that ain't really got nothing to do with it, but, you know, I just want to see where y'all are at mentally. How was y'all week? What's going on?
Oh, for me, friend, like, you know me, I got the kids at home. So I'm real big on my mental health because I know that we could kind of lose ourselves in our daily lives and get stressed out and worried about things. So for me, I'm always meditating, you know. I'm always trying to...
What does meditation look like for you?
For me, friend, I would say, like, I don't know. I'm real big on, like, frequencies and, like, aligning myself. When I wake up, I listen to a certain type of music. It's like meditation music. I don't listen to, like, anything that's gonna, like, put my vibration at low. You know, I put something that's gonna put me in a good spirit, good mood, good energy. I listen to that. I kind of meditate to myself, be to myself, read if I have to, and, you know, do other things. That whatever I feel like I need, if it's a hot, nice shower, whatever it is that I feel like is going to put me at a peaceful mindset when I wake up. Because I feel like when you wake up, that's going to start the mood for your whole day.
Right.
So, yeah, when I wake up, I just meditate. I listen to my music. You know, I get my kids together, of course. But I try to take some time for myself to, like, try to, you know, refocus myself. So the rest of the day, I'm good. I'm not stressed out. I'm not worried. You know, I can kind of handle things better.
Okay. You feel like you meditate?
Do I meditate?
Mm-hmm.
No. Why? I mean, I might meditate in the Word, in the Bible, or something like that. But as far as, like, meditating to music or to sound, no.
Your meditation can be different than other people.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what I'm saying. I might meditate, like, in reading or in, you know, prayer. But for the most part, I don't, though.
You don't?
No. Honestly speaking,
I feel like I just started meditating this year, though. My meditation usually look like I run me a hot shower. I run me some music, y'all. Like, Apple Music got a host station for meditation. I put my meditation music on. I light me a candle, and I just sit in the shower. I like sit down in the shower.
Girl, I'm and relaxing. Usually, just you telling me that I'm gonna relax right
for
now.
For real.
Yeah.
Or even
get you some Epsom salt, huh?
I said sit down in the shower.
So you just got you just got the shower running. That's some
no, you sit in the shower.
No, but I mean, when you're learning yourself, you got to know what works for you.
That's
one
fact.
Thing about your self journey. Right. It might not work for everybody, but that's okay. You're learning yourself. So if that's what helps her make her day peaceful or whatever she got to do, she handle it. That's what works for her. That's right.
That's right.
I'm going to sit in the rain.
You know,
yes.
You got to understand, certain people, they move on different levels. She's becoming one with nature or herself. You never know what journey she's going
through.
You're right. You know?
Because I'm all about knowing who you are and knowing, you know, what you will do. And I like people who are self-aware, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So if that worked for you, that keep you from, you know, biting people's heads off, keep doing that, you know what I'm saying? I'm
all for it. Back in the day, you know, when I was a thug or whatever.
She get real raw.
Yeah. I don't want to live that life no more.
She get real raw.
What days is those?
I can't be telling you that. It's the feds might be watching.
Oh,
so,
Lord.
Yeah. Back in the day when I was a kid.
Oh, you was a kid doing these things?
When I was a young kid, you know,
you was a young kid. Young kid.
Legit young kid.
But, yeah. What do you feel like your week looked like? Oh, I thought they was busting us.
Look, you said the feds coming. I thought they was coming.
Too
soon.
We hearing noises and stuff. What's going on?
Now we all looking. Just like Baby Sia, get on the phone.
Oh, baby. You Sia never answer our question about your calls. Week.
My week?
Yeah. How did your week go?
I thought I answered it in the last episode. All
right. We ain't right, gonna look, have look, him look, as no okay, co-host no,
I'm sorry,
no more.
I'm sorry. Look. Cause it'd be like on the spot. Like I'm not no host type guy. You know what I'm saying? I'm usually the.
You just talking to two people that you.
And
you
we
know,
just asked you about your week.
Genuine conversation.
My week, okay. My week, it was all right. It was a little like it was a little productive, slightly. You know what I'm saying? Made some money, made some plays, had some shit lined up. You know, but it'd be like for me, honestly, because I live like a rapper lifestyle. Monday through Friday be seeming like.
That so your days just all mixed in right now.
Like today is what, Friday, right? I know it's Friday, but it could be Monday and it still wouldn't.
So it seemed like Friday every day for you.
It could be Monday every day. It could be Tuesday every day. It could be
so
Wednesday.
So what day
do? I don't. I'm not like. I don't go out to party and shit like that. You know
what is a rapper lifestyle? Right. I want to know.
A rapper lifestyle is like. What would you say? Might not make it. We might not make it to the mall. Goddamn.
You out partying all night.
No, see, I ain't even no party. I'm just the type nigga. I let where the wind blows. Like, you know, Papa was a Rolling Stone. You know that? Mm-hmm. Wherever he lay his hat was his home, for real, type shit. You know what I'm saying?
You had a lot of hats and a lot of homes.
You got a lot of hats out here?
No, I don't got a lot of hats. They stole them. I used to.
Somebody stole your pimping? What's going on?
They know what's going on.
That's wild. Well, my week.
You know.
Y'all want to know about my week?
How was your week, friend?
Thank you. It's genuine. I feel the love today. My week was okay. My baby actually left me this week to go with his dad. Yeah. Sad face.
When they leave.
Yeah.
Is it like what? Christmas break?
Yeah.
Okay. So how you feel like you sad about that?
I'm sad a little bit, but every mama need a break, so I'm not gonna
lie. I feel like because I got a daughter too, I feel like when mamas get breaks, they'd be like I just in my head I just
they'd know be that like
song?
What?
You know that song, it'd be like, hey, that hoochie mama. That just started playing in my head. Uncle Luke just started playing in my head, like,
so when we just be out here.
If I got my daughter, I'd just be like hearing her mama listen to Uncle Luke. Can I cuss
on him?
Well,
he know what type of baby mama he got.
You know what I'm saying? Not even just my baby mama, but like just when I be like, damn, you got, when she be like, when a girl
so you
tell
me. Trying to say, this Christmas break that I'm going to be out here popping my coochie. He's boxing us in.
What you really tell us? You on a podcast telling all your niggas worldwide. My son just went with his daddy. Text me right now.
That's wild.
Public service announcement. You know what I'm saying? So,
that's what you took from that?
No, that's not what I took from that. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying that we don't know what the audience might have took from that.
Oh,
okay.
That could have gave her more freedom to do more podcasts, to take a trip.
Yeah. She should have some more episodes.
To have some me time, to go to the nail shop.
To take a shower without
a child beating on the door.
Shower while sitting on the floor. That's what she doing.
I mean, that's nothing wrong with that.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
You know, she might not need as much meditation with the baby being gone. You never know.
Hey, look. I'm all for mama's having a break. I love when my daughter come over. I just hear Uncle Luke playing in the background. There you go, and I'm with your mama.
Are you just a holiday daddy?
No, I'm the daddy that gets baby whenever she want to come to daddy. She gets saying daddy. She could be saying daddy at 3 o'clock in the morning. We're going to hop on FaceTime. I might pull up on her, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
But no, not no holiday daddy.
Because, you know, we got the holiday daddies. Mm-hmm. They come get the babies the day before, and they take their pictures on Facebook.
My baby only one, so I ain't even, you know, I'm still learning. I ain't there yet.
Okay, so you got a small baby. You ain't got there yet.
I don't want to be no holiday daddy. That sounds kind of boring. That sounds like an expensive baby.
It's not expensive. That's when the broke daddies. They take a picture with the baby and the mama gifts that they done bought.
Not the mama.
You know what they say? They come take a picture real quick. Oh, yeah. I spent the holidays for my baby.
That's a holla fake daddy.
And they gone.
That's a holiday daddy. No, I thought holiday daddy mean I gotta get you on the birthdays, the Christmases, the Thanksgiving. I'm dropping you off at your grandma's house.
That's still bad. You know, you feel like money is replaced time.
I don't feel like that. Hell no. I feel like you gotta love your baby. You gotta love on your kids. They gotta understand and have communication with you. We don't want no lies or nothing like that. Cause that's how, and I got a daughter, so I just want my baby to be able to understand and You know what I'm saying? It's a lot. But we ain't talking about babies, is we today?
We talking about holidays. Because we're talking about holidays. Right, right, the kids, they need their daddies and their mothers during the holidays. It's about family, you know?
Family, because holidays don't even seem like holidays since grandma left.
Right.
Grandma gone. And it just seemed like holidays just stopped being holidays.
That is true. I've been saying that for a while.
So what is a tradition that y'all used to do during the holidays?
You go first.
I go first?
The guests go first. What's your name? Where could I go?
Lily Marie.
If they want to go.
She already said all that.
I'm sorry.
If they want to find me, I'm on all social media platforms. Zionaire Fashion, Facebook, Zionaire Fashion, Instagram, at the Real Lee.
Okay.
I'm sorry. At the official Real Lee. Mm-hmm. On Instagram. I got Instagram, I got Snapchat, I got everything. So you just look me up and you gonna find me. I'm there, baby. Everywhere you need me to be.
What's going on with this cup right here? Cause
this this is some Hennessy. We got some Hennessy.
That's not Hennessy.
We got some Hennessy.
That's Crown.
All right.
That's Hennessy. It looks like Hennessy. It's brown. It's brown. That's all that matters.
You about to drink this?
Brown and Crown.
I've been enjoying my champagne. Yeah, that's what it seems
like. It's fake. All right, so let's get back to the question, though. So the question was for
the tradition that y'all do.
The tradition that you do.
Y'all want me to start?
Right. Yeah, you start because I gotta get, you know.
Because I'm a holidays girl. I love the holidays.
Yeah, you always out.
So
that's
you know,
like just like an F.
All right, goodbye. We don't need you no more.
Like y'all kind of matching. You got the same colors.
No,
got
I'll put the Christmas colors on for this episode.
Okay.
You did horrible.
Oh,
no, I'm just playing.
Okay, so tell us your.
So my tradition is like my family. We usually open up a gift Christmas Eve at midnight. So just one gift. We also do like the cookies and milk the night before or what a day before. We be in our pajamas. We also do like holidays movies. So literally Christmas Eve is just like kicking it with the family in our pajamas, watching movies, just enjoying each other's time.
So your family, like what, you, your mom, your siblings,
yeah,
pops, grandma,
yeah, no, just the immediate family.
Oh, so just your boyfriend.
So okay, so siblings. Let me explain that. I'm glad you brought that up. No, for real. So Christmas Eve is usually like whoever was within our household, like my dad, my mom, my little brother, and me. Right. So then Christmas Day is when we go and you know spend the time with everybody else, and it'd be okay. Like grandma, uncle, cousin,
type shit. Mm-hmm. Grandma be having a sweet potato pie. Apple pie, cherry pie, blueberry
pie.
I've never experienced the grandma cooking all the food now.
Really?
That's the one thing I've never experienced.
What? I got you, baby.
Yeah, what? I've never experienced that. I've always wanted to. I've always had to go to my auntie's houses to get
that. Can auntie cook, though?
Auntie gonna throw down.
Okay.
Oh, she gonna throw down. I mean, we're gonna have 4 or 5 plates.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing gonna be left. The whole table gonna be empty. So she throws down, but I've never experienced that grandmotherly, you know, everybody go to the grandma house and cook and get presents.
So what would you say was your favorite dish?
My favorite dish? Mm-hmm. I'm kind of fat. You know, I love some soul food. I'm going to eat everything, and I'm going to mix it together because I mix my food like my yams and my mashed potatoes and my macaroni and cheese.
You gonna mix all those three together?
If it depends on if it's touching.
Oh, you eat some jail food. That's some jail food.
Even if my
I'm
my dressing
you right
and
now.
My dressing is mixing with my mashed potatoes, I mix it together.
Your
and
dressing?
I eat it.
Wait.
Yes.
First of all, can we go back to what you just said? Because we had this conversation before.
Where you from? Where you from?
Mashed potatoes and dressing?
Yeah.
Why do you have mashed potatoes and dressing on the same plate?
What do you mean?
That's
when you're
okay.
From the South, you're going to have at least 5 different...
For the holidays, you eating mashed potatoes.
You're going to eat whatever. They cooking mashed potatoes, steaks, corn.
What part of the South is you from?
I'm not from the South. I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Okay, so...
But I grew up in Milwaukee, and I grew up here.
How much time you did in jail?
That's
I'm saying you're mixing all this stuff up together.
I did 10 days and guarantee you I had a canteen. You hear me? I had a starter pack. Went to jail with a pack. You hear me? I ain't had to worry about
making
nothing.
But you
feel
like nothing. She took that and you're still bringing it to today?
She got fucked up in there.
I did my 10 days and I didn't eat none of that food because I had my own little stuff going on. I had my canteen ready when I went up.
She was one of them motherfuckers in there putting.
Soon as the sheet came she on, putting, I'm
she,
ordering.
She putting Snickers and noodles and
I would rather eat that than...
Hell no.
Listen, I'm just telling you. For me, it's the flavoring. I'm a cook. So I know how to mix certain stuff. Mm-hmm. If you a cook, you know.
Okay.
You know how to mix certain stuff to make a different type of flavor.
But mashed potatoes.
If your mashed potatoes, it depends on how you make them.
I like
you,
different
if you got regular mashed potatoes, then you lose it.
I feel like my mixture... The only thing that I feel like I would mix together, it'd be like my macaroni and yams.
Exactly. So you get what I'm saying. So you never had a famous bowl from KFC.
That's different.
Mixed. That's not different. That it's corn, different. Chicken, you mashed
said,
potatoes.
You
that's
said two things. Starches. You
that's
said,
nothing wrong with a mixing Alexis. Mashed potatoes in anything. It's a famous
you
bowl.
Got
it's
two
like
starches. Starches.
I make my own famous
about,
bowl.
You talking about macaroni and dressing.
Mashed potatoes.
You trying the whole plate. You might as well have just chopped it up.
I will eat all that shit together. That's how much I love Mr. Soul Food. I won't give a fuck. What's touching?
So, hey, look, what's that taste like for you? That ending taste?
That taste right there is like somebody just pulled my foot out my mouth. I be just so speechless.
Yeah, it tastes like feet, right?
No, that's if you eat pig feet. And I don't mess with the chitlins. I don't do the pig feet. I don't do nothing with pigs. No pork on my fork, okay?
Okay.
You know what
okay.
I'm saying? I ain't no Muslim. But I don't just get down with that for religious purposes. Thank you, Lord. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He said, don't eat the pork. So I stay away from the pork. But everything
say,
else, I'm going to tear that up.
He say, so, he say don't do a lot of things. But, I mean, we still do them, though.
I don't she do none
no
of that.
Pork. Okay.
I'm
no
a
pork
Christian.
Okay.
And thank you, Jesus. We coming near the holidays. Christmas time is about celebrating the Lord. Mm-hmm. I'm a Christian. I don't do none of that.
Apparently, it's about mixing your food together.
He told me
I'm
to do that.
Try
it
I'm
was
gonna
a,
try that this
yeah,
holiday.
It was an idea
and I'm
he
gonna
gave.
Get back
what you
to
gonna
y'all
try? Hold on. What you gonna do? What you gonna mix?
I'm gonna mix whatever she saying.
Okay, you got you. All right,
wait for the people that's
you like
watching.
Cranberry because everybody
they
don't
mix?
Eat
what
cranberry
what they need
on
to mix together.
For you eat cranberry on your dress?
I don't. I eat hot sauce.
See,
hot
sauce.
Milwaukee all fucked up.
Oh my god,
Milwaukee fucked up. She mixing. Corn, yams, and potatoes.
That's Southern.
And she
my mama put me on that.
She put
okay,
hot sauce.
We got
Milwaukee
South
is not the South.
But my mama and from the South.
Milwaukee.
And they put hot sauce on their dressing.
Milwaukee
that's where
is
I got
a whole
it from.
Bunch of people wait. That originate from different places. And we just all there.
Listen,
you get what I'm saying?
I'm from Michigan. That's right by Milwaukee. I ain't never
Detroit.
Heard no, yeah. I ain't
oh,
never heard of
yeah.
nobody putting no motherfucking hot sauce on
y'all
no.
a different type of breed, baby. Look at the hat you got on. You already look like a you got Jesus, the Jesus hat. With the Moses rap.
He confused.
You confused. You don't, y'all in a different
Christmas.
Type of time. We don't have, you got the Jesus hat on. That's the only hat.
Do you know what this hat is for? This is a any occasion type of hat. Like this
it's definitely Christmas.
This shit can get real wicked real quick.
That's
then he just turned into the ski mask. I don't know if it's Pooh Shiesty or Baby Sia sitting next to us.
Right. That's wild.
And that's the whole purpose of this.
Okay.
So it's
your occasion, huh?
And then if everything going back to being copacetic, then I'll, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's Christmas vibes,
like,
so I got it up. But when I pull it down, I'm the Grinch.
You know who you just look like then? The Santa Claus from next Friday.
Why was stealing? Why you in? Why you in my kitchen? The big ass. I'm making the big ass sandwich and shit.
The one that was stealing everything.
That's funny.
Ho, motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. What would you say your favorite dish is?
My favorite dish for the holidays, like between Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Yeah.
Sweet potato pie, easy.
A dish. Let's not do dessert.
Okay, I mean shit. I'm eating that in breakfast, morning, dinner. But
what,
anyway.
A sweet potato pie.
My
so
own.
You eat yams.
They know to make me my own sweet potato pie because mm-hmm. ain't nobody getting this one. Once yeah. I get it, I'm gonna be petty. I'm gonna take a
that's
scoop right
nasty.
Out the middle.
I thought you were gonna say he's gonna lick the whole pie.
So you eat
I mean,
yams.
I might do that too. I eat what?
Yams.
We
sweet
talking
potatoes.
About food still, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay, make sure. So, no, I'm just playing. You know, I don't know what age range
yams,
this
you
is.
Know,
PG-13 or what it is.
I mean, I ain't saying all that, but you know, the South in different places that we say different stuff. We
right.
say yams,
right.
we say sweet potatoes.
Where I'm from, yams can mean a lot of different things.
Okay.
Come on now.
But
okay.
What I'm saying though, I eat all the yams. just put it out there. We
oh,
eat
you
all
eat all the yams?
Yeah,
that's crazy.
Shit. But my favorite dish would be probably like, you know what I like when my mom be making that hen, like it's not like turkey because that should be dry, but like mm-hmm. duck, like hen, that should be like.
So she just make hen like with nothing else, you know? Some people put hen in their dressing or.
Chicken. Yeah, she'll do like that type shit. Yeah, but like that probably be my favorite dish if y'all make me pick something besides sweet potato pie. Because everything else, like soul food, I eat macaroni year round. Like I'm not the type of nigga that I don't want to wait till November mm-hmm. to eat some motherfucking dressing. I might eat some dressing. On
y'all
New Year's
always
Eve.
Cook, soul food for Christmas?
What is soul food?
Like food for the soul. Food that's make your soul greens, smile.
Macaroni. Yeah, like
it make you happy.
Hot water, cornbread, yeah. Pork chops.
You smell it, you
chicken,
see it, you just get happy.
Collard
instantly.
Greens.
I'm happy Oprah. Thinking about it. And we got Christmas in how many days?
Motherfucking fried zucchini.
I don't know about all that now. You a little too healthy. You a little too healthy for
too
me.
Too much vegetables.
Nah.
Yeah. I'm trying to tell y'all a good skincare routine though at the same time.
Zucchini? Oh, okay. Come on, because we all, we black women, you know, we all with the aesthetics. What's
love,
going on?
I love vegetables. Y'all just got to eat more vegetables. Vegetables is good for your soul, like you said.
Okay, vegetables. I feel
but
that.
That's not considered really soul food. You know, black people
use. No, I name like every damn thing we probably eat. Cornbread, collard greens, yams, macaroni.
But every Christmas, y'all don't switch it up?
Switch it up,
my mama might like do some like, I ain't gonna lie, shit, we ain't did shit different. I ain't gonna cap.
Have you?
Yes. I kind of suggest, like, instead of like an actual turkey, I say like turkey wings, turkey legs.
Yeah,
that's still soul food.
Like, no, it's like not duck. Because you're kind of switching it up. Like, do some ribs, like some steak ribs.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Yeah, yeah.
Do some, you know, just kind of do different stuff.
Yeah,
I mean, of course, we love our traditional dishes, and I feel like it's okay with that because we only get it kind of like once a year. So, it's nothing really wrong with that. But if you kind of switch it up, there's nothing wrong with that. That's why I said potatoes. And you was like, what about potatoes? Because I like to switch it up. Mm. I might do steak and potatoes instead of the traditional ham and turkey and all this
you know
stuff.
What we do
you
we,
know
we do a breakfast every like Christmas
do
like,
you know
that's wow I haven't heard
like,
of that one.
Actually last Christmas we didn't have no food, like you said. We did have breakfast. I'm mm-hmm. trying to think about
like
it.
All day.
Okay. No, like we had breakfast that night. We had breakfast for dinner.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Type shit.
And who was the one that prepared it?
My sister.
She was all out house. What she made?
Well, it was regular.
I love
pancakes,
me some breakfast.
Browns,
and you was smashing
sausage.
It while you saw my awesome.
So y'all ate that for what was that Christmas?
Like, we was at her house late. We was playing games and we was eating breakfast. It was like I want to say like the night before Christmas probably.
Oh, okay. So y'all made your own tradition. Y'all made basically. Something, and that's nothing wrong with that.
My sister probably came up with that shit. I don't know. I just showed up when they be.
That was last year.
Group chat. Sorry, pull up. I'm about to bring the weed. What y'all need?
I don't know if we can say all of that. but no.
He's talking about the plants, the real plants.
Yes,
Bringing the syrup.
Add
bringing some out
the
for the
food
pancakes.
Dishes. It's cilantro, folks. Anyway, you know, I feel like it's okay to make our own traditions.
Yeah.
Because I feel like we've been following the same rules mm-hmm. for so long.
It's
why
a
not?
Cycle.
You know, it's a cycle. And it's not a pretty cycle, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like for some reason our generation is the ones to kind of break it mm-hmm. and
yeah,
shift
it.
You know what I'm saying? We do our own thing.
2024.
And
they don't know what we're talking about. Keep going. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know, I'm just saying, like, so genuinely, I feel like our generation is the ones to break the cycle. Yeah. You know, we don't
really
do
is.
Everything so traditional. Our parents are the ones who, you know, stick to this.
They're the NPCs. Yeah, they're the NPCs.
Exactly.
They go,
and we kind of the ones.
They never
going to
quit their job. They're going to go to work every single
every
day. They robots.
They got that pension.
But
we're going to
ask questions. We're going to be like, what the hell is a 401k?
Exactly.
First off,
exactly. And how often do I get to use this? Do I get to use this as
how the hell I get a penalty for pulling out my money?
Exactly.
You know what
you
I'm saying?
I don't.
How do I get a penalty for pulling? Wait, you mean
what
to tell me?
What you just
me?
Call it?
A penalty? Is that what it is? See, that's what I'm saying. What
you
the
said
hell?
A 401k.
What is that?
401k? Yes.
I thought it was a radio station. Listen. For a second. Shit.
What you pulling out of that 401k?
Listen,
I thought it was K104.
Put it into the air. That's your new little radio station.
That
okay.
is hilarious.
But no, that's what I'm saying. Like, our generation, we going to question it. The generations before us, they just going to do it.
Accept
they NPCs, you know, and that means non-playable characters. But that's a conversation for another day.
Yes.
Y'all want me back on here? It can get real deep. I
all
can
right,
teach
y'all.
So,
I actually got my own tradition,
free,
you know.
Free Rashad Jamal, by the way.
Okay, because he was speaking that truth. And I'm with you on that. But I ain't gonna talk about all
yeah,
that.
Talk about
y'all
that.
Ready
yeah,
to
ain't
switch
talk
the
about
topic?
That.
Just saying, man. Free,
but it's the truth. We know the truth is the truth. Okay.
Anyways, mm-hmm. I have my own tradition that I done started on a podcast. It's our first year, but you know, can you stop?
Oh my!
I was gonna give y'all a gift,
I'm
but
feeling jolly.
You feeling jolly?
That was my gift.
Okay, Santa Claus.
You yeah. welcome.
So what is we getting for Christmas?
That's what I
we
said.
Ain't getting nothing. He done stole the
he
Christmas.
He done ruined the
A gift for me, friend.
I'm feeling like the Grinch.
I don't know if it go with my attire. Child.
Too much. Damn, what size is this? Well, it can't be one size fit all.
That means you got a big head. I told you that.
You got a big old head.
You got these out the kid off.
If well, I can fit it, then you know.
I don't even know.
Hold on. She can't fit that
much. I can't even fit it.
All right. It's cute.
But
though.
It's cute. It I can is. Still right. see Thank my you. My baby hairs. That's all that matters for me. I mean,
this is crazy.
Yeah.
You look like you about to steal Christmas.
Don't rip the tag off, because we got to take these back. This is not
now
the
Now we
got to
take these back.
We got children.
You can get them to kids.
Exactly. Right. What you talking about taking back? We don't take nothing back around here.
I do.
I was going to say.
Girl, bye. We don't take stuff back around here. They going to fit it. If they don't fit it now, they going to fit it in about a year.
I'm taking this hoodie back after this podcast. What you talking about?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
We know you lying.
You definitely missing
the thing. We know you lying. Yeah, you done dropped, what is that, Crown Royal?
It came off in the dryer. I didn't mean for that to happen.
You what know. Would y'all say? You talking about returns. What is one of the worst gifts y'all received for Christmas?
I didn't receive a lot of those.
Not having a gift.
That's the worst gift?
Yeah. Do y'all, women, some women think sex is a gift.
Our it's, presence is more so a gift.
That. Why she you go straight to women, though?
She wanna, I'm sorry. Not to. Don't feel targeted or nothing like that.
We talking about overall.
Overall, she tried to wrap that coochie up and give it to me. I'm
she
like,
really
I
wrapped it up?
Did she wrap it up for real?
Right, look, did she wrap it up for real?
No, she wanted me to wrap it up, but still.
There's nothing wrong with wrapping it up, okay. sir. You should wrap it up every time, even when it's not
no,
Christmas.
No, I'm just playing. But no, our coochie is not a gift. So I will say that's probably just not even, like, fuck Christmas. On my birthday, I couldn't even get a happy birthday.
You sound like
Well, that's a little harsh.
I don't even, that's a little harsh.
I don't even expect nothing for Christmas because I like to get, I'm a giver. Mm-hmm. But, like, if I'm doing shit all year, giving, at least give me a motherfucking, like.
She did. Her coochie.
Card. No, that's not a gift.
She said.
That's not
that's
a gift.
The gift
that's
that keep on giving.
That's all she could afford
it's
at the
gifts
time.
That keep on giving. It, so yes, she's going
to
give you.
To her, that is of high value. I don't know how much you have valued that, but to her, that was high value.
Very value.
Sold to the next man. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I don't know. I don't really get a lot of gifts. I ain't going to lie. I'm more the person who gives the gifts. I'm not the person who gets shit. Mm. I'm not the receiver.
So you ain't never received like a bad gift?
My mama give me socks and cologne every year.
And you love it?
I appreciate
How
that
How do you
shit.
Open your gift when she gives it to you?
I don't open it in front of her because it's not
I mean,
even, it's not
but listen,
up.
Socks, you going to need them. You get holes in socks.
Gonna
you walk
warm.
Around and
hey,
get dirty.
I appreciate them.
You lose them. Need, socks is something running, we
I'm,
need.
Mama know I'm running this shit up. I need them socks. Mm-hmm. But what I say though, nigga do appreciate the cologne and shit too, you know. Even though I don't wear a tag.
What is tag?
Exactly.
Hopefully Moms is not watching this. If she is, you know what he do not like.
No, hey, we can take the tag sponsorship though. We fuck with everything, you know what I'm saying?
What's the worst gift you done received?
Child.
You said plenty, so.
I didn't receive, so. But I'm just so humbled.
I know. I want to
so
know your
grateful.
Reaction, though, when you open that gift.
Oh, this is amazing.
What is it, though? Tell us.
I think the worst gift I've ever received was probably a shirt that I think was thrifted.
What?
But
did it have a tag on it?
It did not, but it looked it pretty thrifted.
I mean, they might be a thrifter.
What was the
though.
Shirt, though? What, it was an expensive
it
shirt.
It was not. It was just a regular shirt, but it was just like.
Graphic tee?
The thought that, no, it wasn't even that. I don't even know. I would say maybe working on the slave ship type ship shirt.
Oh, so it was Kanye made that motherfucker.
It was something very unique, and I appreciate it because it was different. Mm-hmm. It was something that I've never. I probably
you don't
wear
even know.
It
Harry
to
Tubman,
clean the toilet.
Harry and Tubman wore that shirt.
Yes,
you don't
she
even
did.
Know.
And you that's probably, what I wore it for. I wore it to from... save the house. Every time I needed
to
save everything around the house, I wore that shirt. And I saved everything. The toilet, the walls, the couches, everything. And I wore that shirt. And you know what? It actually worked out in my favor. Because I didn't get my cute clothes dirty.
Okay. So
it
was useful.
It was useful. And I love
Shout
useful stuff.
Shout out to whoever
stuff.
Gave her that.
Shout
that
out
shirt.
To you. Yeah. I might need yeah. another one.
Mm-hmm. And what's yours?
I don't receive bad gifts.
Oh, that's something. So why you ask this question then?
She a little bougie know, something. You know,
so every gift is a good gift?
Yeah.
So not having a gift is a good gift?
I don't care. I'm a giver. So Christmas is just like.
Okay, so what's the one time? What's the one time
you gotta say something?
Yeah, what's the one time you gotta get?
I mean, my mom done told me stories, but I mean, truly, I don't remember that because I was a kid.
So you never got a bad gift.
Something. So have you got a gift lately? From any recent Christmases? And what was those gifts? Did you appreciate it? Did you not appreciate it?
Or what was the best gift that you got?
That's who.
Dang, y'all put me on the spot.
Yeah, because you can't just not say something and then tell us to say something.
Dressed up as a Grinch and shit.
I wouldn't say it was the best gift, but it was the most thoughtful gift. I got proposed to on Christmas.
Oh, that's real. That's
well,
real.
That's I ain't never received no gift like that.
That's kind of sexy and shit like that.
That's not sexy.
That's a little favoritism, Santa.
Not Santa.
Sorry, what shit. Did I do to be so naughty?
Yeah, I was just gonna say.
Yeah, I guess it's usually. I don't really care about receiving gifts on Christmas. I'm really a giver. I feel like that's why I like the holidays. So I'm the one that be in the store like, oh, I think they like this.
Oh, girl, you are the like gift.
Thank you.
Okay.
Period. Somebody feel me. So I really ain't never received a bad gift. If I had to say a bad gift, I don't even want to say that was a bad gift because...
Girl, say it.
But I ain't never wore it either.
Exactly. It's a bad gift. You ain't wore it yet.
What was it?
We need to know because I didn't put my grandma on the spot. Sorry,
okay,
grandma.
Okay, look.
And listen.
So, I received a U.S. Polo Assassin t-shirt. And, you know, that's not me.
That's good cleaning attire.
Wait, what's wrong with U.S. Polo Assassin?
It's nighttime attire. Ain't it wrong
that's
with
just
that?
Not my brand that I like.
Why, because it got Assassin on it?
Yes. It just wasn't me.
Or because it's got the USPA on it.
It got multiple people sitting on top of a horse.
I was one of those kids that I loved polo when I was like,
that's no, not polo.
That's
and I would
that's,
never, I would that, never
that's
wear.
That's the assassins US, that killed polo.
So why wouldn't you wear? Why wouldn't I wear? Because I only wear Ralph Lauren. But
so what's wrong with USPA?
Nothing's wrong with USPA because it's just like nothing wrong with Adidas. Ain't nothing wrong with Nike. It's the same shit. But thought that matters. They gave you what they could.
Which
is fine, but I don't even wear polo. I don't wear Ralph. So
if you don't wear Ralph, then you should fuck with USPA. You know who makes
or
that?
Or I should not fuck with neither one because I don't like it.
Oh, so you just don't like
it. It's a purple, no press.
Maybe he was trying to tell you something. Like, he was like, I hope you like horses.
It is horseback riding attire. That's why it was created.
Horseback riding attire. She fucking is it.
Oh, it's a horseback riding attire.
I'm trying to help you all, guys. She fucking it up over here.
I'm just saying. It is. That's what it was created for.
No.
The jockeys.
I, me personally, my mama would buy me USPA and I'd be like, Mama, you know this ain't the right polo. I was not talking about this one. We got to go get Ralph.
Which ones
my
did you want?
No. My mama know.
Which ones was it that you wanted?
Ralph Lauren.
The big
logo. When the big horses came out.
With the numbers on the side.
The big horse, for sure, the $60 boys. Yeah. Give me one of them.
So if she gave you a gift and it was USPA.
My mom.
And you opened it.
You talking about in 2010 when this was going on? Or you talking about right
never.
Now? Right now or
both.
2010?
What are you saying when you open that gift?
2010, Sire. Mama, you know this ain't the right one. What is you doing? 2023, Sire. Okay, Mama, appreciate this. This one to get hung up, never worn. Might give it
you don't
to
think your
mama's
gonna slap you upside the head?
Well, my mama wouldn't do that. I'm grown.
In 2010?
Hell no. I was in 2010. My mama would buy me whatever I would want to. Like,
but if she bought you that, and you said that to her when you opened that gift, you don't think she'll feel like you were very unappreciative?
My mama knew better. She would never buy me no USPA. What the fuck? She knew better. Like, I wasn't. I
you
wasn't.
Might as well not give me a gift.
Okay.
Look, not no shame on the thrift. We would go in the thrift and buy polo shirts for like $10,
$15. Ain't nothing wrong with thrift.
Because we would go to a thrift store and get all the Ralphie. Mm-hmm. The thrift store.
Goodwill. Goodwill ain't even a Goodwill no more.
The thrift store.
Goodwill ain't even Goodwill no more. They charging
$400
for TV.
I grew up on Goodwill.
Boycott Goodwill.
Bullshit.
She just said they went up on TV.
They went up, and Goodwill is not Goodwill.
On TVs? I never
bought
a TV. Goodwill
is not on everything. Goodwill is not for the poor and less fortunate no more. It's for the rich that's trying to thrift. That's what it's for.
I mean,
because
shit.
They didn't went up on their prices. It's sad.
I ain't been to Goodwill in a minute, but I grew up on Goodwill.
I ain't either,
for sure.
But I've been hearing stuff.
We gonna go thrifting.
I ain't going no thrifting.
I'm not
paying $400 for nothing that I can go to the actual store and pay $200 for.
Hey, I fuck with Goodwill.
We can still go thrifting. And we might find something good. I think that should be another episode, like a return of the thrift.
No. Return of the
So what we gonna do? We gonna go to the thrift store. Yeah, we gonna shop and wear the homeless thrift. People clothes that they peed in.
Y'all should go to a thrift store and see who can find the best outfit.
You gonna go?
I'll go.
They gonna have to comment I'll put that down below, I just told like, y'all. And share this video and get it like up to a whole lot of views if they think I'm finna do something like
we
that.
Is. Okay. How about that? So when we do,
don't doubt it now. Cause how many likes and views it gotta get?
I mean, don't I would say overboard. I ain't gonna go overboard. I would say at least 100 likes, comments, shares, or something.
We can do that.
Child, I'm not doing that. So I don't trust homeless people.
No, what did you talk about homeless people?
That's who donate to the Goodwill.
No, they not. That is crazy.
How the homeless people gonna donate? And somebody they ain't got shit donate. The homeless people is. The homeless people outside the motherfucking Goodwill.
How they can't donate? Afford nothing at the Goodwill at this point. Listen, I don't know.
I you just said the homeless people donating.
Somebody donating, but it ain't me.
You just said the so homeless people can't donate.
It ain't me donating. I don't trust it.
Look,
that's
why. I didn't been homeless.
So how
homeless.
You know they the TV's $400 in here?
Somebody told me. You know, I was watching TikTok this morning. Somebody told me. I was watching some girl on TikTok, and I believe what I see on TikTok because TikTok is the new television news anchor. So I believe it.
I know you fucking lying.
You I don't want to watch TV no more. I just turn on TikTok, honey.
Yeah.
That is crazy.
I ain't gonna lie.
Y'all, I didn't
I
even
watch.
Know my best friend thought like this. This I turn is on like YouTube. Really surprising I turn on YouTube. Me right now.
Knock the hat off of me. I'm trying to tell you.
I won't let you live down that you just said homeless people donate to the Goodwill.
They do.
And that's why you don't shop
there.
They
go outside and they got them blankets and they don't want them blankets no more. And they go take them blankets to the Goodwill.
Well, what?
To,
they don't
because
get
they
want to
share with the next homeless person.
They not buying no damn blankets off the homeless
They might try to get some money.
Street.
You never know. Crackheads always trying to get some money out of all.
They be donating plasma and shit like that.
Yeah, they might donate that blanket thing. They finna get 50 cents. You never know.
That is wild.
I'm pretty sure it's a few homeless blankets in the Goodwill.
That's fine. I'll take me a homeless blanket.
I would not. For $300,
will.
Alex. No, thank you.
Have y'all ever been Christmas caroling? Okay, I guess I'm just the only one that liked the holidays.
I grew up in Detroit, Michigan, Grand Rapids,
you
Michigan.
You better not go to nobody doorstep singing no song.
Yeah, what Christmas carol? Where did you grow up?
In Milwaukee.
They gonna sing you a carol, all right.
That's what they doing in Milwaukee?
That's what we doing.
Y'all me. Out there.
Jingle bell, jingle.
No, I don't know no black person that's out there caroling in 2023.
I know.
You come to my neighborhood
y'all
with that.
Seen
we gonna
TikTok? People out here caroling in Ulta.
Where the fuck is Ulta?
Ulta is a beauty.
It's a makeup store. Like
Ulta, supply store. It's beauty.
You ought to know what I'm talking about. Sorry, no.
That was so corny.
You the one that's talking about Christmas caroling.
All right. So, going forward, do y'all feel like y'all going to have a tradition now?
Yeah, when I have a wife and a family, we can make all the traditions in the world. And
you gonna leave that in her hands, or you gonna?
Why do he have this ski mask on talking?
Because I told y'all gave me this hat. I'm the Grinch.
You look very Grinchy right now. Yeah. It's giving you stealing the show.
Y'all lucky I ain't reading the buffs in here. I would have put my buffs on.
Okay.
I'm stealing the show because I got the ski mask on.
Yeah, you stealing the show. You got the ski mask.
I might
mask
rob
on.
The show.
All right.
I'm trying to make sure
he
everybody
not,
know my
he
friend.
Not. I know he fucking lying. For real, for real. You're not welcome back.
Oh,
at all.
I think we should leave that to the audience.
He not welcome back.
Because okay. If we're going to go to Goodwill and
me,
we're going to find the best fit, y'all going to need
traditions,
me.
But that's my personal preference. I'm kind of separate from a lot of things that people kind of keep up with. So, no, for me, traditions, I don't really uphold them, but I have children, so I try to make the best out of every mm-hmm. situation for them, for their sake. But me, as far as me, no. I don't keep up with anything like far as traditions and holidays and all of that. I feel like it's a whole bunch of waste of money and a waste of time, honey.
Okay. Well, y'all know at the end of every episode, we play the game, I Know You Fucking Lying. Because y'all been lying like a motherfucker. All
child,
the way up to
I
this
keep
point.
It real.
Which
I'm
is
the
so
realest
crazy
friend
to me.
You ever got.
So crazy
plus
to me.
Years, honey.
I don't know. So basically the concept of the game is I ask y'all something and y'all tell me like, okay, so we're going to say, for example, if I say, how many radio shows can you name? And you'd be like, oh, I can name 4. And then he'd be like, I can name 5. And I'd be like, I can name 6. And y'all call my bullshit, be like, I know you fucking lying.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got to Like, name six.
Okay.
And then if I can't name six, I'm going to have
keep
to take
it
a
simple,
shot.
Pooh. Keep it simple. Keep it simple.
Okay. Okay. You think you got not something in mind? You got something in mind? Y'all want
to? It's Christmas episode. We got to do some Christmas thing.
Okay. Christmas, well, I had something in my mind, but Christmas I didn't know movies. If y'all did. That's what I was going to say, but that's when. So, you want to start it off then, since?
I could name five Christmas movies.
I already know what he about to say.
I can name six.
Yeah, I can name about.
You gotta go up. You can't go down.
Seven.
Either one can call. I know you fucking lying.
Why you gotta do it?
You could have called her.
Yeah,
you
no, too
called
late. Bluff.
Uh-huh. I call your bluff.
No, we know you fucking lying.
Home Alone 1.
Mm-hmm. Alone we ain't 2. Doing that.
Uh-huh, no, them movies. No, them classic we movies. Ain't doing one, them classic movies. What you look like right now?
Motherfucking The Grinch.
Okay, so how many is that?
Cause, that's five.
Okay.
It's multiple ones. It's an animated version. It's a human version.
I fuck her. You know what I'm saying?
I should make both of y'all take a
well,
shot.
I got one more. I got one more. Yes. This Christmas, you know I got to put my Tyler Perry
it's
in
it's a
there.
One and a two.
That's not Tyler Perry.
Tyler Perry did make This Christmas.
I'm going to have to Google
with Chris
that,
Brown and all them.
That's not a Tyler Perry movie.
How you know?
Who made the movie then? Who did
it? I made the movie.
Girl, bye. She swears she's a Christopher. That's not Christopher fan.
Christopher Columbus.
And she know. Oh,
that's my man.
Not too much on him, okay. Honey. He is the GOAT.
Christopher okay. Columbus.
We will jump you on this podcast. You
hear Christopher real Columbus quick. Ain't even.
You won't sure. Make it out of here alive. Just kidding. Just kidding.
I hope I don't.
It was. I knew it wasn't. You want to know why? Because my man is Chris in there.
I so know. Chris don't deal and with Tyler Perry is what you trying to tell me?
He ain't did no movie with Tyler Perry. Okay, I know what so his business be.
It's still a Christmas movie, though.
Okay. Yeah. So it, how many? That's you going to go to the next one. Oh, you
one,
got it?
1, 2, 3. He said 1, 2, 3.
How that's many did four. You say overall? You said 7
I said
or 8?
Seven.
That was 5. I said 8. That was definitely 5 movies.
Okay, you
we
said.
We just going to give it to you because I feel like you the name most of them because you was up here BS.
What's that one Christmas movie when they rolled the little metal thing all the way from the house to the store or some shit? You know what I'm it's an no, old I movie. Don't.
They wrote what from the store?
He wrote like a little trash can top or some shit to the store. Dude, never mind. Go. Go with the store.
Okay. Right. We're going to do one more before we head out. So how many Christmas songs can you name?
Christmas songs?
Yeah. Or you can sing them or you can name the song.
All I Want for Christmas, Mama Right.
I said how many?
Oh, how many?
So you go.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I probably can name like 5 Christmas songs.
I call it bullshit. All
right. You ain't even gonna give a number. You're just gonna be a go.
Okay.
Yeah, at this point. Okay. I got All I Want for Christmas. Mm-hmm. Jingle Bells.
Mm-hmm. No, Jingle Bells don't count.
That yes, do count. Silent Night.
We need black songs.
No, Let It Snow.
They got Jingle Bell.
The black version.
Okay. The black version.
Let It Snow. Jingle Bells all the way. We got Silent Night.
This is not Silent Night.
Jingle Bells too.
Can you just go ahead and take your shot?
Hold on. I got one more song. I said This Christmas. I said Silent Night. I said Jingle Bells. I said
Jingle Bells
too. Feliz Navidad.
What is Jingle Bell too?
I know that one.
I don't know. It was on.
Can you just take your shot?
Nope.
What else you got? Okay.
A new song that I just made. It's a Christmas song coming soon. And
you just
heard
said you
yet.
Made it. Yeah, it's coming soon.
Yeah, it's coming soon.
She dropped
but then you just say you
that's
made
my 5th song.
You
I ain't
just
taking out
make
no
it.
Shots.
It ain't make sense.
Child, listen. That's 5. You
okay.
Got what you wanted.
I think she gave us 5. You can give one more.
Can I give you one more?
You know,
that,
I don't know no other
Christmas. You could have did All I Want for Christmas.
I did
that. By Destiny Child. And
12 Days of Christmas. Okay, I did that. That's 5.
Let's see.
That's 5, cool.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
That too. Yeah, that's it. That's it. That's all.
Merry,
I
wish you a Merry Christmas.
How you forget Rudolph is a red-nosed reindeer?
Because I'm red-nosed. They call me Rudolph. And if my nose be turning red, I know that nigga nose was red and
if
bright.
If my nose turning red, then
no, I'm like, get it. I'm a red bone. See, you don't know this concept of red bone. You don't get it yet.
All right,
red bone,
all right.
You understand.
Well, I appreciate y'all coming on this episode. Again, tell us where we can find you.
Lily Marie on all platforms. You can look for me under Zionaire Fashion. TikTok, She Funny, She Dope. Mm-hmm. IG, The Really Official. Twitter, Lily Marie Designed It. But yeah, I'm everywhere, baby.
All right, what about you, baby Saya?
You can find me on all social media at BXBYSIAH. That's Baby Saya, all platforms. If you're looking for clothes, you can find me Allergic the Brand. That's spelled just how it sounds. That's it.
And you can find us, as you guys see, look, I'm looking at Too Familiar Podcast on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. We're on all platforms, basically, wherever you listen to your podcast at, check us out. And we appreciate y'all for tuning in for another episode of Too Familiar. Bye.
Bye.
And happy holidays.